Hey, Crypto Warriors, it's Ultra Crypto back at it again. Today is Friday, April 2nd, 2021, and it's been a slow news day today. Well, so far, it's still early in the morning, so we'll see by the end of the day. But big news was Bitcoin broke 60K and Ethereum broke the 2K mark. They're retracing a little bit right now. Not too far off from where they were a couple of hours ago. So, still pretty much in the green. And is there anything significantly in the red? Yes, Filecoin. And I have some Filecoin news today. Wow, Filecoin is down almost 20% for the day. And yeah, that's pretty much it. And Doge is back down to 5 cents. So, I hope you took your profits off that Elon Musk pump. All right, let's get into it. Coming from Cointelegraph, Bitcoin beats out final resistance as Ethereum returns to 2K. So that, like I said in the beginning, we saw Bitcoin briefly surpass the 60K mark, as you can see by the charts here, right? So let's have a quick zoom in. And it wasn't a full candle over the 60K, but we broke it nonetheless. And we are currently back down right now. And the same thing for Ethereum. We broke that 2K mark. Those are big, significant, what do you call it? Psychological resistance for some reason. I don't know why. Because in my opinion, Bitcoin should be anywhere between 75 to maybe 90K per Bitcoin right now, with all the adoption that's happening right now between PayPal allowing people to use cryptocurrencies as a form of payment to their over 300 million merchants worldwide, to big banks like Goldman Sachs finally jumping into the space after Bitcoin went up many hundreds of percent since they claimed it wasn't an asset class. They did a full 180. So again, we have huge adoption news for Bitcoin, and not only Bitcoin but Ethereum as well. And we're still lingering at these prices. I don't understand why, but yeah, it is what it is. But don't sweat the prices on a daily basis. As long as you're dollar cost averaging, that's all that should matter. All right, next, like I said, I have big Filecoin news, and Filecoin Foundation donates $10 million in File tokens to Internet Archive, so the Wayback Machine. All right, so the Internet Archive, an American nonprofit behind major digital archive Wayback Machine, has received a $10 million cryptocurrency donation from the Filecoin Foundation. A digital librarian and a computer engineer, Kale founded the Internet Archive back in 1996 with the bold with bold efforts, and this is a quote, with bold efforts to record the entire internet. Wow. That takes up a lot of files. All right. The entire internet. He expects that new technologies like Filecoin will help further transform digital libraries by making them more decentralized. Libraries have always used the technology of the day, whether it's cuneiform back in the Sumerian Babylonian times or papyrus paper or microfilm. Today, the Internet Archive is built on hard drives. Our hope is that new technologies like Filecoin will revolutionize the storage market and decentralize it. And we are thrilled to collaborate with an organization that shares a like-minded approach. The Internet Archive is an early cryptocurrency adopters. The nonprofit has been accepting donations in major cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, since 2011. Since its inception, the Internet Archive has received more than 880 Bitcoin on its publicly available Bitcoin address, with a total balance amounting to 4.5 Bitcoin as of right now, around 270K at the time of writing. So the Wayback Machine, if you want to look back at anything in history that's been on the internet, you could definitely use the Wayback. I've used it in the past to look up certain things where I couldn't find it right away on Google. Just type in Wayback Machine in the Google search, and then you get on the website and and do your search there, right? And you're able to find pretty much anything that has been on the internet and that has been open on the internet here, mostly in the Eastern world. I'm not sure about stuff that's happening. I'm just saying Eastern world, in the Western world. I'm not sure about stuff happening in the Eastern world, like in China, because they have an intranet and they're closed off from the rest of the world. So, but if it happened in the news or if it was something like a big deal, it's pretty much you could find it on the Wayback Machine. So, great news in the form of Filecoin donating to keeping the internet open and decentralized. That is very important, in my opinion, at least. All right. Next, this must be their, talking about Cointelegraph, their go-to for CBDCs, their go-to graphic for CBDCs, because this was the graphic they used for the Jamaican CBDC that I reported on the other day. All right, Bank of Thailand to begin central bank digital currency tests in 2022. Couple months, well, not a couple months, about what? We're in April now, so 8 months away. Well, actually Q2, so a whole year away. They'll be starting to testing out their CBDC, and as we see, more and more countries are coming out with their CBDCs. Now, I'm not for CBDCs per se, because it is another form of control, because they'll be able to control the amount of spending and or saving that their individual citizens are doing with their CBDCs and their digital wallets. So if they give out their stimulus checks, using the United States as an example, they distribute their stimulus checks to all their citizens around the world. I mean, all around the world, here in the US, and they want to quote unquote stimulate the economy. They will put a stipulation on it that states that, well, this money that you have from us has to be spent within X amount of days. All right, you can't save it, and if you don't, and if you try to save it, then it'll disappear from you. I'm just giving an example there. So I'm not for CBDCs. However, because of CBDCs, my viewpoint is it will lead people to see that a truly decentralized form of money is the way to go, and it will just push them to adopt Bitcoin more and adopt Bitcoin even faster. So, back in March, it's stating that Thailand Apex Bank deemed the Thai Baht Digital, all right, the THT, a stable coin issued by Terra to be illegal. At the time, the central bank cited the country's law prohibiting any other entity save the central bank from issuing currency in Thailand. So Terra, a cryptocurrency, issued a stable coin and call it the Thai Baht Digital, right? And the Thailand government wasn't going for it, all right? Or the Thailand Central Bank wasn't going for it, and they deemed it illegal. This is what that this is the problem with stable coins, right? That there is a point of attack. They could go to the company that's issuing that stable coin and then tell them to cease and desist. Not so much with a decentralized form of money like Bitcoin or even Ethereum, right? Ethereum has decentralized stable coin like DAI, and they really can't attack it, right? So again, they have a point of attack. They could attack or send their lawyers to tell them to cease and desist and stop issuing that stable coin because it's illegal. And yeah, so there you have it. They tried a thing and it didn't work. All right. Next, we have the IRS. More news coming up from the IRS. The IRS is hunting for tax dodging customers off Circle. The IRS has received a green light to request information about certain customers of cryptocurrency payments company Circle. I've never used Circle, so I am glad. But then again, I don't try to hide from the IRS. I've been audited in the past, and it's not a nice thing. The IRS, or the Internal Revenue Service, now has the ability, has the authority to check whether customers of crypto payments company Circle filed their taxes correctly. Specifically, it's chasing after customers who traded at least $20,000 in crypto from 2016 through 2020. I would say 20,000 within a 4 year period is not a lot, because if you were trading Bitcoin back in 2016 and you just basically held it up until, the height of 2017, then you made a lot of gains, right? So, yeah, 20,000 is a lot, isn't a lot. If it's during just a 1 year period, then yes. But 20,000 during a 4 year period, not a lot. So, and it all depends on the appreciation of your current cryptos as well. Yeah, so they're coming for you, man. They're coming for you. The IRS is coming for you. And I just highlighted this other section right here. And this is coming from Decrypt, by the way. Last month, the IRS launched Operation Hidden Treasure, an anti-tax fraud initiative aimed at seeking out underreported cryptocurrency transactions. Working together with the agency's criminal division, the initiative targets dark net money transfers and so-called mixing services that why can't I say that word? Obfuscate. Wow. Crypto transactions. Tax dodgers are running out of places to hide. So yeah, if you're using a mixing service, I guess they have the Bitcoin addresses of those mixing services or the crypto addresses of those mixing services, and they can see the inflows and the outflows as well. So yeah, just be careful out there, man. And yeah, it's not a nice thing to get audited, and it's a pain in the ass. But yeah, crypto taxes, the IRS is coming for you. And they're not giving you much of a room to like play with here, because they're looking for $20,000 within a 4 year period, and that's really not a lot. That's basically 5 grand each year. Now if it was 20 grand per year, that'll be different. Within that calendar year, that'll be different, in my opinion. But yeah, try to report your taxes correctly, and watch out for the tax man. That's it. Thanks for watching. Smash that like, hit that subscribe button, the notification bell to get notified when I upload new videos. This is Sergeant Crypto, and I'm out. Peace.